In this presentation, we will see how to declare functions in C. So let's get started. What is function declaration? As we already know, when we declare a variable, we declare its properties to the compiler. Like for example, this is the way we declare a variable, and the properties of this variable var are as follows. Name of the variable is var and type of the variable is int, that is integer. Similarly, we can say that function declaration, also called as function prototype, means declaring the properties of a function to the compiler. Like for example, this is the way we can write the function prototype. And the properties of this function fun are as follows. Name of the function is fun, that is you can see over here. Return type of the function is int, that is integer as you can see, this is the return type. Number of parameters are 2, type of parameter 1 is integer, and type of parameter 2 is character. And please remember that function prototype always ends with a semicolon. Okay, this is important. It is not necessary to put the name of the parameters in function prototype. Like for example, here you can see this is the function prototype, and in the parameter list, you have written the name of the parameters as well, which is not necessary at all. It is not necessary to mention these names. You can simply write the data type of these parameters, and that is enough in function prototype. Although, if you write the name of the parameters as well, then it is also correct, but it is not necessary. And one important point to note down is that it is important to mention the name of the parameters in the function definition, but it is not important to mention the name of the parameters in function declaration. Okay. Now let's consider one example of function declaration. Here you can see I have declared a function fun whose return type is character, and there are no parameters of this function, right? After this, we have a main function, and inside this main function, I'm simply calling this function fun whose definition is written over here. This function will simply return character A back to this place, and this character will get stored inside this variable C. And after that, we simply print the content of this variable on the screen, right? As we know, compiler scans the code from top to bottom. Therefore, it first sees the function prototype. It sees that the return type of this function is character, and there are no parameters of this function. Inside this main function, compiler simply calls this function, and the control passes from here to here, right? Compiler first cross-checks this definition with the function prototype. That is, it matches the return type as well as the parameters. In this case, the return type is character in the function prototype, and there are no parameters as well. Therefore, in the definition also, the return type must be character, and there must not be any parameters inside this function. Therefore, this is correct. After that, this function will execute successfully, and it will return character A back to this place. And this character will get stored inside this variable C, and it will get printed on the screen. Let's see what will be the output. Character is A. Now let's get back to our presentation. Is it always necessary to declare the function before using it? The answer to this question is, it is not necessary, but it is preferred to declare the function before using it. Why is it not necessary? Let's see with the help of an example. Here you can see in this code, I have not written any function prototype, but I have defined the function before actually calling it, right? This is also one way in which compiler can know what is the return type of the function and how many parameters this function will accept. Therefore, either you will write the function prototype or simply define the function before calling it. This program will also work fine. Let's execute this program. Yes, it prints character is A. What happens when we use the function before defining it? Better if we see it live in code blocks. As you can see, I'm simply calling this function before actually defining it or declaring it. So what will happen in this case? Let's execute this code. it produces the error, conflicting types for function. Also, it produces the warning, implicit declaration of function fun. What is the meaning of implicit declaration of function fun? As you can see in this code, I have not declared the function before using it. This means that compiler implicitly assumes something about this function. As compiler have no information about this function, that what is the return type of this function, how many parameters are there in this function, and what are the return types of those parameters. Therefore, compiler implicitly assumes something about this function. And what it assumes that this function must have a return type integer. So with this assumption, it simply calls this function. And when it calls this function and comes to this point, then it sees that this function is having a return type character. Therefore, it is a conflict. That is why this error will get produced. That is conflicting types for function. What it assumes is that this function must have a return type integer, but when it comes to the definition, it sees that this function has a return type character. Implicit declaration simply means compiler assumes implicitly that the function has a return type integer. Although it won't assume anything about the parameters, but it assumes that this function must have a return type integer. Whenever you won't declare or define the function before using it, then compiler implicitly assumes something, and if the type conflicts, then it produces the error. Okay, friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.